Hey, what's up guys? It is Jonas here with GoDaddy's Farm. Today we're going to be showing you a video on building an enclosure for our Kinkajou named Zaboo. So Jason didn't really tell me when we're going to go in and start, but I guess I'll just go ahead and start filming now, see what he's up to. So let's go.
Hey, yeah, Jonas. Oh, video time already. Sweet. Alright, so that was supposed to be funny for you guys to walk in and see me singing. Jonas edited some laughing, added in right here. And so we are working on the new Kinkajou enclosure. We just wanted to show you guys a brief overview of what we're doing. First off, the reason I love doing projects like this when we are not open is because I make a complete mess. Jonas pan around to see the complete mess in our farm store. Everything is torn apart. Freya's in here, of course, supervising. We've got windows and doors and drills and screws and everything else torn all over the place. So we're going to be working on getting that tidied up really, really quick. But first, we're working on getting this enclosure done for Zaboo. Zaboo is a Kinkajou, K-I-N-K-A-J-O-U. Be sure you spell it right on Google, otherwise something bad might pop up. He is a Central and South American animal closely related to raccoons. So he lives outside right now, and on really cold nights, we'll bring him in and out. And it's a really big pain in the butt, and I don't like doing it. He makes a mess in the house. It's gross. So we're building this inside the farm store, so he's going to have his own heat and AC. And we wanted to show you guys kind of the process. Jonas is also going to put some pictures in here before. He hasn't been working because it's been Christmas time, so he didn't get any early videos of us building this. But essentially what we got going on here is he's inside of our farm store, so we're in here. This is 20 foot from my bedroom, right outside of my house, so I come out here all the time. But this is a door that we've made for him, a very heavy duty door with nice latches. I've got to finish the trim and everything, so don't judge everybody. You wait till the final end of the video. But this is the door. I made it up high so that I have to step in. If he's down on the ground running around, I don't want to take a chance at him running out. Even though he can get out in here, if I'm in a hurry, I don't want to have to catch him and play with him and all that stuff to get him put back up. And we've still got to cut some more framing boards and everything to put back up. But it's 8 foot by 8 foot by 8 foot. Room for him, and I got lucky at Lowe's and was able to get a window that was being returned by somebody. So this is a nice tempered glass window. He's got his own vent right here, so I just turned the heat on, and we're gonna frame out this vent so there's no chance of him pulling it down. And we're changing this light out also, so this light will actually be a spotlight that'll shine to this back corner over here. And we're gonna put lots of tree branches and things like that in here. And he's got ventilation here so that he will have access. Our air conditioner vent is gonna be on the outside for him so that I can keep the temperature in here between about 60 and 80, 85 degrees at all times. In the summertime, it'll be about 80. And then in the wintertime, it'll be the coldest of nights, it'll be about 60 degrees in here, which is totally fine for these guys. But we're gonna deck this out. It's gonna be awesome, exciting. I'm so happy to be doing this. This is gonna be like a zoo-like enclosure. But we will catch you guys up in a little bit. Peace. Gloves, and we ended up having to grab Zaboo. I had to grab him from behind the neck. It's just really hard to take them out of their house, and I did not want to chance a bite. He's a very nice Kinkajou. I probably could have just picked him up and taken him, but he wouldn't get on me, and I had to put him in the kennel to bring him in here, and every time I tried to get him in the kennel, he was fighting to get out of the kennel. So every time I've had to get him for shots or anything, I always have to kind of restrain him by the back of the neck. And just quick move, boom, boom. We use a cat carrier, so the top of it, there's an open on the top of it, so I can just set him down in there. He's probably restrained for all of maybe 5 seconds max. But we've got him in the kennel. Jonas has him here. Jonas said that he'd be in the video this time, be the eye candy for the video. Thank you, Jonas. Everybody clap. Be sure to drop a like for Jonas. Thank you, Jonas. We like videos that Jonas is in, so like and comment and tell us that you want to see more Jonas. But can you see Zaboo? Can you walk up with him? See if we can see him. So this is Zaboo. We've had him for a couple years now. We're gonna put in the comments below how long we've had Zaboo and a little bit of information about where we got Zaboo from. and what situation he was living in. Now, I am not telling anybody this information because I'm encouraging you to get a pet Kinkajou. I saw these guys in Costa Rica in the treetops at nighttime running around, and there's no habitat that we can build in captivity good enough for these guys. It's really pitiful that we, you know, I've got the, my favorite animal that I have is my dog, my Chihuahua. And I always encourage people, stick with dogs, stick with cats. You don't really need to get exotics. But we ended up with this guy, and I thought that this was gonna be the end of the video, us releasing him. But as you're gonna see in a few minutes for you guys, it's a whole like 24 hours for me. As you're gonna see, during the process of building this cage and getting everything set up for Zaboo to be inside the farm store, we had some new news come up, which is good and bad. So yeah, you guys are gonna see that. But first you get to watch us turn Zaboo loose in the cage. So we'll show you a few seconds of Zaboo enjoying his new cage. And don't forget, we still have a lot of decorating to do inside. This is just the bare minimum basics. We've covered the entire cage with fruits and veggies and monkey biscuits and all kinds of stuff for him. We're gonna go ahead and turn him loose, and yeah, we'll summarize all the events of everything at the end of the video. But yeah, thanks.
Peace.
So, story time with Jason, because this is kind of a long one. I'm gonna cut it down. Jonas, if you can make my voice go fast, that would be awesome right here. But essentially, we got Zaboo a couple years ago from a horrible situation. Pine Tree Hill Wildlife Rescue and Exotic Animal Rescue. Pine Tree Hill Wildlife and Exotic Animal Rescue went in and they rescued him from a guy who just bad situation, horrible situation. He was underweight, marked up to Pine Tree Hill, got him back healthy, and I just had back surgery, so like a month after she got him, I got him. But we got him, and we, you know, he's been great. He's been awesome. He's been living in an outdoor enclosure. We'll take him inside occasionally. If it gets too cold outside, we'll take him inside. He's got a little heated house outside. He's a neutered male. We really don't have any information at all about him, but he's great. You guys have seen previous videos. Jonas and Cam put one of those little things pop up right here at the top of the screen. Actually, I think it would be right here, so they can click on the other video if they want to learn more about Zaboo. So we decided we wanted to be able to take him out and let him run around on us and kind of work with him a little bit, maybe make him a animal ambassador, and be able to handle him in front of people. So putting him inside the farm store gives us a nice enclosed safe area that we can take him out and do that with. We started Christmas Eve building this enclosure for him. Worked on it Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, day after Christmas. The next day we got a call from same wildlife rehab and said, hey, we're another Kinkajou. And that was just so surreal and so insane that happened at the exact same time that we were working on this enclosure, Josh and I and Jonas. And so we were like, yeah, could not have happened at a better time. And this girl was an under surrender. She seems pretty healthy. She's been, we've got the information about her from the veterinarian that she was seeing before. And she was at a great place called Izzy's Pond, which I'll put a link in the stuff below for them. Check them out on Facebook. They're an awesome, awesome rescue. Do a lot of wildlife rescue. But yeah, so we went there, picked her up today. Today, it's New Year's Day. Yeah, so we drove up there this morning, picked her up, got her back home. Now, she is in a kennel inside of here. We are going to leave her in here probably until about 5 or 6 p.m. It's December right now, so when the sun goes down, it's actually January. Wow. When the sun goes down, we are going to Happy New Year. We're going to see how her and Zaboo interact. We held him up to her to kind of see if there was going to be any immediate aggression. There was none. They just kind of sniffed noses. Same thing he did with the dogs and cats. There may be some hissing or spitting or something like that, but as long as there's no damage caused from one to the other, that's the main thing that we're going for. But so Josh and I are going to have a late night ahead of us. The goal was to put this kennel inside of another cage, but we don't have one that this fits in. So we're gonna do this. I've got gloves handy. I've got a blanket handy. I wanna send a special shout out to Kinkatopia. So it's Kinkatopia. Look them up on Facebook, send them some love. Anybody out there who's watching this video because they want more information about their Kinkajou, I am not an expert. I definitely am expert enough to say don't get one as a pet. They're not great pets at all. These guys probably, I might touch them. Well, I touch him every day, but I don't like handle him. I just like, boop, love you, and feed him, and that's it. So yeah, without further ado, we are going to go ahead and leave these guys alone, let them get used to each other's smell. This is a new cage for both of them. sorry. The biggest Kinkajou is having some issues navigating his way through the branches. But yeah, thank you for Josh for not killing me. He rode with me today. It was really awesome. We are going to update you guys in the future. I don't know if it'll be after this or it'll be in a future video. If it is, we'll be posting the video next week. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to subscribe. This new girl's name is Cleo. And of course, there's Zaboo. So we hope to be posting some cute videos of them hanging out together.
Sister Cleo, calm down.
Husband for sale. So yeah. Anyways, we're going to be posting some future content with these two guys together. I cannot be more excited. Thanks for watching. Click the alert bell. Subscribe. Leave a comment down below. If you have a Kinkajou, let us know what your experience is. I really want to show video of these two guys being introduced together because I cannot find any information except from Kinkatopia. If you bust out laughing again, I swear. But I can't find any information except from Kinkatopia. They're the only resource that I have on Kinkajou care. So.
Kinkatopia.
So yeah, without further ado, we're gonna leave these two lovebirds alone to hopefully get along, and peace. All right guys, so we've had Cleo now for 3 days and we have made a little bit of changes in how we're gonna progress with introducing her to Zaboo because she's so stressed out right now due to moving from her previous home to Izzy's Pond Rescue and then moving to our place. I wanna bond with her a little bit before we introduce them and also let her calm down some. We're keeping her in here. It's nice and dark and quiet. So I'm gonna take you guys over here and show her. We're actually using a Ferret Nation cage right now to keep her in. And she can see Zaboo, but they can't harm each other, but she's gotta do a lot of calming down first. So I'm gonna show you guys just real quick. Hi, baby girl, hi, Cleo. And we're not gonna stay in here long because I don't wanna scare her, but I've got her nice and covered up. She's got a little kennel in there to keep her nice and calm, and she gets in the kennel and cuddles up in her fleece blanket. Hi, baby, hi, baby girl, hey, sweet girl, Cleo. So her name was actually Chloe, but as many of you know, we have a border collie named Chloe, so the next best thing is Cleo. But she is here. Hi, Cleo. Hi, baby girl. So I don't want to stress her out, so I'm going to leave her alone. I'm just going in there a couple minutes every day and feeding her, changing her water, cleaning out any poops that she may have. But yeah, I just wanted to give you guys an update at the end of the video just to let you know what's going on. And be sure to subscribe and hit those alerts because we will be doing an update. I may end up moving her inside of the house once she calms down a little bit and hopefully bond with her a little bit so that it's easier for me to interact with her whenever I'm putting her and Zaboo together. But yeah, stay tuned for another video and thank you guys for watching this far.
Here, let's get some video, Jonas. Give me the camera. He says he looks too ugly to be on there. And I agree. But, you know, content is content.
Are you done? Are you done? Are you done? You got my 2 minutes. That's all I got for you.
Shut up, Josh.
Welcome to Goat Daddy's Farm. I'm Carter Sauce. You can check me out at Carter Sauce Music on YouTube. I make raps about anime and stuff. But today, we're at Goat Daddy's Farm, and we're going to prank Jason today. If you didn't know, I used to milk goats here and work in the dairy. But today, I do not. We are going to prank Jason. He doesn't know I'm here, and I don't think he's here yet, but we're going to get in this new Zaboo enclosure that we're building right now, and I'm gonna get in there, and he's gonna get here. Has no idea I'm here, and we're gonna scare him. So yeah, let's jump into it.
Say what? Just putting that in the center of the pen?
No, I'm gonna hang it up on the wall.
Gotcha.
How am I making this?
I knew something was going on because of the way he was talking.